As an international relocation consultant, I've done approximately 1 bazillion property searches in my life. And so in this video, I'm going to share with you 27 other websites and strategies you can use to find housing for your next trip. You'll probably even save some money too. So these are in no particular order, but the first website that I'm going to share with you is called PlumGuide. And I first found PlumGuide because I was looking for a long-term rental property for a couple that I was relocating to London. And they are based in the UK, so they had a lot of beautiful properties there. But as you can see, they have houses and apartments in different destinations around the world. We have LA, San Diego, New York, Paris, and this is not where you're going to find the cheapest properties, but you can find some really nice, luxurious properties for about the cost of getting a hotel room per night. So here we have a property that goes for an average of $135 per night in Lisbon, Portugal, and it has 3 bedrooms and 2 bathrooms, so that's a really good deal. And just like Airbnb, you've got your photos, you've got the map so you can see where it is, and all of the details and amenities. Putting in my dates for 1 week, you can see that it's gonna cost you about $1,000 for the week. And $1,000 for the week for this really nice centrally located apartment is not bad. Now for this next tip, Google is definitely your friend. So what you're going to do is go into Google or your favorite search engine and search for executive rentals or serviced apartments. So executive rentals before the pandemic were apartments that were catering towards business travelers that were staying on a weekly or monthly basis. So they're great for remote workers. They're usually fully equipped, mostly have kitchenettes or kitchens, and also high-speed Wi-Fi. So instead of just looking for vacation rentals in your destination, type in executive rentals. Let's try Vancouver. And you'll come up with some ads, and then also a few different types of rental agencies that offer executive rentals. Here's one in downtown Vancouver that is specializing in luxury rental suites. You can choose the type of housing that you're looking for, furnished or unfurnished, and specifically search for short-term monthly rentals. You can do this anywhere in the world. Here is a website that has properties in Melbourne, Australia, and also Manila in the Philippines. And here we have a 2-bedroom apartment in the Philippines that's going for about $113 US. And the longer that you book these properties, the lower you can get your rate. One of my favorite executive rental agencies is Corporate Stays, and I have been booking with them for over a decade now. They started in Canada, so they have a lot of destinations throughout Canada, but also around the world. Here we have Hong Kong, France, Greece, Switzerland, Argentina, Brazil, Australia, New Zealand, Mexico. So you can just hop onto Corporate Stays and compare and contrast the prices you find there with what you find on Airbnb. Another Google search strategy you can use instead of serviced and executive rentals is searching for short-term or long-term rentals plus the destination that you're looking for. This way, you can come up with local realtors and rental agencies that might have properties that you don't find on Airbnb. I also like to use this strategy with Google Maps. So here, I just did a general long-term rental search in Google Maps. I found this agency here. This is a company I've never heard of, but here they have 1-year rentals, long-term rentals, all different types of rentals, and this is a French company specializing in rentals in France. So when you search this way for a specific destination, you're gonna find more local results rather than just hosts on an international site. I just did a quick search here in Provence, and we have some nice properties starting from just around 750 euro per month. So pretty good deals. Oh, this one's only 550. My fourth tip is to use local realtors, but by finding finding them through the local MLS site. So this is the multiple listing system in different countries. A good website for this is called Point Two, and this is actually the same website that my brokerage used to use when I was working in real estate in Costa Rica. So you can go ahead and pick the destination that you're going to and see which rental properties are available, and then contact those realtors directly. So here I just clicked on Aruba, and then I'm going to check Aruba apartments or houses per rent, and you'll have a lot of results coming up. So if you see something that you like, you can check out the photos and the property details, and then just scroll over here to the right and contact the representative directly. So this is another creative way to find long-term or short-term furnished and unfurnished properties. Here we have one in Coronado Beach in Panama for only $750 per month. You can go over here and text or email Guillermo Ruiz and inquire. Next, I'll show you how you can use the local classified sites in different cities or countries to find really good deals. So we've all heard of Craigslist and some of these international classified sites, but you can also find local ones that specialize in that destination. So here I am on a very popular website in Mexico called Vivanuncios, and you might need to translate this into your local language, but here we can find rentals in Playa del Carmen, houses, apartments, vacation rentals, or even rooms in rent. And these prices are showing up in Mexican pesos. So let's click on apartments for rent. Here we have a two-bedroom in Playa del Carmen Centro, which is going for about 16,000 pesos per month, or $800. You can do this by searching for classifieds plus short-term rentals, long-term rentals, vacation rentals in any city that you're going to. Here's another example in Amsterdam in the Netherlands, where we can find some two-bedroom furnished apartments around 1,700 euro. Here we have 1,250 euro, and you can get a lot of good local deals this way. If you're not getting the results that you're looking for, translate classifieds into the local language to be able to get those local sites to pop up in Google. My sixth tip is to use expat rental sites. So there are some international sites like this one here called Just Landed, but there are also typically local expat sites in different cities or countries. So here on Just Landed, I'm going to click on housing, and depending on which country you're looking on, you're going to find a lot of different options. Here we have some fully furnished private properties or flat shares starting from around 300 or 400 euro per month. We also have a private two bedroom around 800 per month. So you can find some really good local deals for less than you might see on Airbnb. My seventh tip is to use a website called sublet.com. On Sublet, you can get short term, medium term, and up to 1 year rentals. You can also find private, furnished, unfurnished, or flat shares. You can sort with the map here, or you can put in your filters by month, week, or day, all different kinds of lease terms, and the size of your property. The next website I want to share with you is called NestPick, and I really like this one for searching internationally because it's one of the largest websites in the world for furnished apartments. They pull in results from more than 200 different websites to provide you with one of the biggest selections of mid and long-term furnished rentals in the world. So you can check almost any major city on the planet, and well, you can spend a lot of time looking for properties on here. Another great international property website is called Housing Anywhere, where you can rent rooms or apartments, and you can stay for as short or long as you want, but it's really good to find monthly rentals. Here we can find over 1,600 listings in Vienna, Austria. You've got all of your filters here on the side to get only the properties relevant to your search, but we can see with a quick search here that you can get a pretty affordable room there for a few hundred euro per month. Let's say you want a furnished two bedroom in Vienna, that's going to start around 1,100 or 1,200 euro per month. Next up, we have Flatio. Flatio, Flatio, Potato, Potato. doesn't matter. What does matter is that you can get a lot of great mid to long-term, fully furnished and equipped rentals on this site, especially if you are looking for housing in Portugal. So this company is based in Portugal, so you've got a lot of listings throughout the country and also around Europe, but they're adding new cities every day. The cool thing about this site is that you can search by the town that you're interested in. Maybe you want to go to Poland. The prices are really fair and reasonable, and if you stay for less than 6 months, you don't even need to put a security deposit. Here you can get an entire apartment for as low as 760 euro per month. Next up, we have another one of the biggest and oldest vacation rental sites in the world, and this is Vrbo, which has recently merged or acquired HomeAway. So those used to be two of the biggest sites back in the early 2000s, and you can choose family-oriented properties, pet-friendly properties, and search with a lot of different features. The benefit of using Vrbo is that they have such a big database because they've been around for so long. And just like Airbnb, you can also search for cabins and cottages and unique styles of accommodation. A downside to Vrbo is that it can be expensive. So it's not the most budget-friendly option, but you can find some really unique properties here and get an entire house or villa for the same price as a hotel room. Another website that I really like is called Nine Flats, and here their tagline is feeling at home away from home. And as a long-term traveler, expat, or remote worker, that's what we all want to feel. We want to make our home where we are and feel at home anywhere. So I love that mindset. Here we have some villas in Bali starting from only 10 euro per night. You've also got some luxury hotels here, but you can find some really good deals, some really luxury rentals, and everything in between. And next up is another one of the biggest property rental sites in the world, and this is tripping.com. So they have an API where they are also pulling in rentals from all different sites. Here I did a search for Phuket, Thailand vacation rentals, and I'm finding houses from only $17 per night, $58 per night. So this is a really good website to go to get a lay of the land and see what the prices are around the world. Another website that does the same thing, and you might even see their results on other websites, is called Home2Go. Lots of people claiming to be the largest selection of vacation rentals, but at least you have options. Another site that you might have used before to either book a hotel or a flight or even a rental car, but it also has long-term rentals, is Trivago. So here I'm looking at some apartments in Bangkok, Thailand, and you can get a serviced apartment. Remember, that was one of our search strategies. 29 nights for $704, so pretty good. They'll even compare and give you different options for where you can book it. Number 15 is not a vacation rentals website necessarily, but it's this Inspirato Pass. So you can pay a monthly fee of $2,500 per month and get access to their selection of rental properties. This is one that I haven't tried, but I definitely plan on doing it because it's just a way to save you time in this whole property search process. You know the properties have been vetted, you know that they're in good locations, and that they are catering towards long to medium term travelers. So they're gonna be fully equipped, good Wi-Fi, everything you need. This is a really good option to look at if you're going to be traveling around the US specifically, but they also have a couple properties in Central America and South America. So if you have a $2,500 a month rental budget, but you don't have a lot of time to be looking and searching all over the internet, Inspirato could be a good option for you. My next suggestion is to try co-living. So co-living is where you are renting a room or a suite or apartment in a house or building with shared common areas. So your living areas, kitchen, dining room. Kowali is a website that I've used a lot in the past. And then we also have Kindred, KNDRD.io, where you can select a city or a country, and you can find all different ranges of co-living, from more shared hostel-like situations to more high-end luxury co-living with your own private room or apartment. If you're working online and traveling at the same time, then time is very valuable to you. So a benefit of using co-living is that a lot of times they'll include laundry services. Sometimes they'll include meal prep, or they'll have a cafe in the building. It's all about quality of life. So you're meeting people, you've got community events, activities, and then you can also have someone to cook for you, do your laundry, and it's really like a full service experience sometimes. In this location in Barcelona, you have different rooms at different price ranges. So you can have a basic private room, a double room, and then it can go up from there. Here we have a room with a private balcony and a bathroom for around 43 euro per night. Lots of really cool options on this site. I definitely recommend it. Similar to co-living, instead of finding a private rental property, sometimes you can join a co-working or co-living retreat group for the same price per month as you would spend on your housing. Some options include Remote Year, Hacker Paradise, and Wi-Fi Tribe. Let's check out this Wi-Fi Tribe trip to Cape Town, South Africa. You've got some different villa options here, and you can join for about a month at different rates. So it depends on how long you're traveling with them for and what level of accommodation you're getting. A shared room can be from $200 to $2,400 per month, and a private room from $3,400 to $3,900. And this will depend on the location as well. My next tip is to use Facebook. So you can use either the Facebook Marketplace or Facebook groups, and you can actually search housing specific groups in the location that you're going to, or you can join traveler, expat, or digital nomad groups and post in there if you're looking for housing. You can even check classifieds groups on Facebook for the destination you're interested in. So here we have some housing available in Tamarindo, Costa Rica, and you can search specifically for property rentals, put in your filters, and then here is an accommodations group just specifically for Malta over in the Mediterranean, where you can find home shares, rent or buy. Some people are posting what they want, and then other people are posting what they have available. Many times these properties are direct with no agent fees or commissions, so you can save money there, because in Malta, if you're renting long-term, you're typically going to need to pay an agency fee. So this is a good way to get some local properties, save a few hundred or even a few thousand dollars, especially when you're taking those Airbnb booking fees into account. If you've traveled anywhere in the world, then you've probably used TripAdvisor at some point. But did you know that they own multiple vacation rental and property rental websites? FlipKey is one of TripAdvisor's brands where you can find fully furnished apartments and homes all over the world. Another one that TripAdvisor owns is called HouseTrip. This is a really good one to check for rentals in Europe specifically. A couple other general travel booking websites that you might not have considered for a weekly or monthly rental are hotel websites like booking.com and agoda.com. Because these sites are so big, you're gonna find a range of properties, so set aside some time to really go down the booking.com rabbit hole. But this is another way that you can find apartments, cabins, villas, and even hotels and hostels. Agoda is also on the remote work bandwagon now because you can get monthly stays. So they have a whole new category to make it easier for you to search monthly rentals. This next tip requires a little bit more energy and effort, but it's a strategy where you will book a nightly or weekly or sometimes even a monthly short-term rental in the destination that you're going to, and then you want to hit the pavement when you get there. So this is a great strategy if you're going to be staying in a place for at least a few months or up to a year or more. You'll rent a short-term rental and then go around, either walk, bike, rent a scooter, rent a moped, hire a local driver, and go around looking for rent signs in the neighborhood that you want to live in. I have found some great deals this way, and I've spent many hours searching for rentals in person. So you'll want to look for rent in the local language. So in Spanish, this would be se alquila. In Dutch, it would be te her. So in some languages, it might be in a different alphabet, Serbian, Bulgarian. So you want to recognize what does for rent look like, and then go out and try to find some of those signs, text or call the numbers, maybe even have a translator do it for you. I've had friends find apartments for $100 or $200 per month using this strategy in Chiang Mai, Thailand, for example. And it does take more work, but usually that work will be rewarded. Now, let's say you own your home, but you still want to travel without necessarily selling or subletting your home. A good option for you could be a home exchange website. There's one called Home Exchange. There's also one called Love Home Swap. So this is a way to keep your home base, but still explore the world. Home Exchange has over 450,000 homes, so I'm sure that there is something you can find. On Love Home Swap, you can just put in the country that you live in and where you'd like to go and see what comes up. Cool. So by using a home exchange site, in this case, if you had a one-bedroom apartment, you could save almost $1,000 on your trip. Another great budget way of finding housing is using a house sitting or pet sitting website like Trusted House Sitters. So you can just search for homes that are available where maybe people are traveling or going on vacation and they can't leave their dog, cat, snake, horse, whatever it is, home alone. So it's a win-win for the owners and you. You get a place to stay and they get someone to take care of their pet. This is a less flexible way of traveling, but it is a great way to save tens of thousands of dollars per year on your housing. It's also a great way for just a weekend getaway. Here you can take a quick trip to Austin, Texas for 3 days, take care of Mary's sweet cat Fiona, and there you go. Another alternative way of finding housing is to rent a van or an RV. Here I'm on indiecampers.com, and instead of renting a house or a hotel room, you can just rent an RV and explore. Here we have the Nomad Van and the Atlas 5, which is gonna run you around $60 to $80 per night, but you'll get to cover more ground that way and see the countryside and also have your housing included. So instead of renting a car and an apartment, just rent a van or an RV, experience that van life, and you might even spend half the price of a hotel room. Another cool way of finding places to stay is by camping. I really like this site, Hip Camp, where you can search any location around the world and find campgrounds for really affordable prices. Here in Australia, well, Australia is kind of closed right now, but you can find campsites for $5, $15 per night. So this is, maybe you don't want to camp all the time, but this is a great way to diversify your housing. So you're not always spending top dollar on a luxury rental in a city, but sometimes you're getting out in nature, having a different experience. Just bring your Wi-Fi with you. So bring your hotspot, bring your 5G SIM card, and make sure that you can stay connected if you're going to be working or take a little technology sabbatical, hit the road, and save money at the same time. My 26th tip is to use budget websites like Couchsurfing, Hostel World, or even volunteer sites like Workaway or Woof, where you can travel low cost, but you can also have a really memorable experience at the same time. Here in Cambodia, there are over 100 opportunities. Here is a family business that needs help with their online marketing and graphic design. So you can stay in Siem Reap, Cambodia. You can help this family with their online business needs, and you can meet locals and have a good place to stay. So this is a great way to give back and have a really fulfilling and meaningful experience at the same time. And my last tip is for if you are going to be in the US and Canada, and one of the sites that I really like for finding apartments is PadMapper, because it pulls in listings from a lot of different sites. And I like their MO here, making apartment hunting suck less. This is a really fast way to check a lot of availability in a lot of the major cities throughout the US and Canada. And another website that does something similar is called Hello Landing. Hello Landing Landing is reinventing apartment living by helping you get out of inflexible leases. So this is a great place where you can have a membership, you can rent month to month, and you can access thousands of apartments on a flexible lease term. So this is a $200 annual membership, but that way you're not locked into a one-year lease or an unfurnished apartment where you have to buy furniture. You can kind of move around cities across the United States. All of these properties are fully furnished. They have kitchens, they have dedicated workspaces, so you won't miss a beat. What is your favorite way of finding short or long-term housing? Will you think twice now before using Airbnb? Let me know in the comments below and enthusiastically hit that like button if you liked this video or learned something new. Check out these playlists for more travel tips and subscribe to my channel for more videos that help you work online and travel the world. What do I want to say? Commit. Well,